Okay, here we go with tonight's watch list for Wednesday, September 26th. Today we had another great day in the market. It was a little volatile. It kind of slowed down for most of the day near the lunch hour. But we were able to get a couple good trades in the morning. And I have some new picks for you and some old picks and some updates. So let's continue on right now. You're listening to a Day Trader Rockstar, and this is the nightly report and watch list for the next day. First one on my list, of course, is Surf Technologies Holdings, SIRF. This one's moved into my number one pick because the beautiful chart it's forming here. An inverted head and shoulders. We've got a shoulder here, a head, and a shoulder. Looks beautiful. I like it a lot. Just closing right now over the 50-day moving average after a four-day pullback, which was very nice. Everything's textbook here. This one looks really good. I expect it to go up and close this gap around 2350. So you're looking, you're looking at a three-point move. And it looks really good. So I've been adding to that one. I have 500 shares of that. This next one, of course, I've been pushing it all week. It hasn't broken out yet, but it is about to. This is the big one, Intel Systems. All right, as you see, back in July, they made the first high on the handle of this beautiful cupping handle. Came back down, consolidated around the 50-day moving average. Came back up to resistance at 26.50, pulled back to the 50-day moving average, and now we're back up to the 26.50 area. We pulled back a little today, a little under 26, but everything is still holding steady. It looks great. We could even get a second handle on this, which happens a lot. So 26.50 is going to be the breakout on this stock, and I would guess this one easily has $28, $29 in it. Probably more as the hype of the new computers and the Apples and everything for the Christmas season are going to be they're going to be ramping this up in the next 3 months. Tomorrow we have 3 months until Christmas, so think about it. What are the hot items going to be for Christmas this year? Apple iBooks, iPhones, computers, electronics, video games, everything tech. So this is gonna this whole tide is going to rise all these boats and all these stocks. This is a great cup and handle, classic formation. I love it. Look for this one to break out at 26.50. Next one we have up is a new one to the list, USU. I got into this one earlier today. I got in great volume, 80 million shares, or maybe that's 60 million. 60 million shares, 80 million, 60 million. I would say 60 million shares. And, consolidating right here on the bottom, USU, they do nuclear uranium conversion and gas and some kind of crap like that. Who really cares? All I can tell you right now that the volumes in this is a big bottom in this is being made because of they just recently offered a bunch of reoffered some shares. It caused the stock to go down. Now it's consolidating. I don't see much downside here. I would give you you could actually put your stop in at a lower low, and I would buy on a higher high. So anything above today's high, I would be in it. This one looks good. I mean, I think this one's going to gap up tomorrow and just head up. So look for this one to hit $11 soon. More of a dangerous play, but either way, it looks like a safe bet from here. Microsoft, big softy, nice move today. I told everyone, get in on the Halo play. Tonight they should be coming out with the numbers on sales for Halo, first day sales. They're expecting over $200 million in sales. So that's if they come anywhere close to that, I can see this one popping to $30 very fast. $30 is going to be the first point of resistance here. And then we're going to be heading up to $31, $32. Easy trade. Great hold into Christmas. Here's a short that I'm considering just because I ate there recently and I think they suck. $115 for Chipotle Mexican Grill. God, is this one inflated? Look at this bar right here. Classic Hanging Man, Shooting Star, whatever that candle is right there. It's a bearish candle right there. I'm going to short this one tomorrow at the open. I don't care if it's going higher. I want to short this one. This one is way oversold. This is a fraud company. I don't know why they're... How could they be... Have you gone into one of these stores? You can't even figure out... You know, there's four things up on the menu. They consider this like a great store and great food. I mean, how can you pay $115 for a stock that only sells beans? I'm shorting this one tomorrow. NMX. NMX. NYMEX Holdings, New York Stock Exchange stock. Just a nice consolidation here. They've been talking. Rumors are abound. Stock, the options are telling us this thing's going to be trading above 145 down the road. So keep an eye on it. Look for the volume to come in. If you're a day trader, always have it up on your list and be ready to get in it because this thing's going to move. And when it moves, it likes to move every 10 days or so on rumors. And I think we're about due for some rumors tomorrow or the next day. So look for this thing to retest 130 in the next couple days. Next one, housing stocks. Housing stocks are getting real cheap again. CTX, trading about $26. You know what? I think this one, you know, has a bounce in it. I'm not going to say much more than that. I still think housing is going to go down. The prices are going to go down, but I think it's due for a trade. It's really pulled back off its 50-day moving average. It's really nice reversal today on volume. This one, I think, is going to continue higher tomorrow. Next one, Beazer Homes, same story. I'm not going to bring that one up. And because the Dow is so toppy, I want to introduce you to the dog. All right, the dog is a stock that you would short the Dow. So if you believe that the industrials or the market is overbought and is due for a pullback, a way you could trade this is by going long dog, D-O-G. And... So I would consider this. If the market starts to trend lower, here's a play that you get into, just like going long a stock. A lot of people don't like to go like the short. So here's a play where you're going to actually go long a stock as the market's going down, and you know you're doing pretty good. And speaking about the Dow, let's bring up the chart of the Dow fast. Take a look at that. What really gets to me is, you know what, this daily chart's not telling us much, but if we go down to the 15-minute chart, let me see if I could pull this 15-minute. I don't even know if I have it on this one. Periods. I don't even have the 15-minute. Well, I wish I had the 15-minute up for you right now. It's on my a different charting program. It's kind of a cheap charting program, but it works good with the videos. But if you look at the 15-minute... chart, you'll see that we're right on a trend line and we're about to break down low, you know, break through that trend line to the downside. So watch that trend line on the 15-minute. I wish I could bring it up for you. You know what? I just don't have it and I'm tired. And I got to get this posted, and you're listening to Day Trader Rockstar, and I hope you enjoyed tonight's watch list. Stay tuned tomorrow morning for a pre-market update, and then we got a noon update, and then a close update, and then again and again and again and again and again. If you like what you're listening to, please subscribe to the channel and leave any comments you wish. If you have a pick or anything, you know, do whatever you can. We're all in here to make a lot of money, so let's do it. Good night.